Welcome back, disc golf fans, to the Swedish Open, part of the Swedish Disc Golf Pro Tour. And welcome back to Ymergården Disc Golf Center in Borås, Sweden. A beautiful course, a beautiful day. I'm Simon Tarman Sävström, and with me I have Rickard Sköld.
Great to be back, and I think we have some great action ahead of us.
Indeed, this is the final round of the MPO Front 9. We saw Dennis Augustsson, and this is Hjalmar Fredriksson.
And we have Linus Karlsson, two-time and reigning Swedish champion. And I think a lot of people showed up here today to the final round just to get a glimpse of this local hero and national star. And Dennis Augustsson is a lefty who plays for the hosting club Ymer, and he's known for making huge putts. And I hope we get to see some of that action today.
This is Fredrik Bodell, a new face to me. He's from Bollnäs in Sweden, 972 rated. Will be fun to see him throw.
Indeed.
Hjalmar still on the top of the lead card and the leaderboard. Actually tied for fourth, Fredrik and Josef and Blair at 8 under par.
It's not over until it's over. And this is hole one with OB on the right and a lot of rough on the left side. You want to stay on fairway and don't want to go too far because there's an OB over there as well.
Let's hear some tee off songs.
2 minutes top.
Maybe first a group photo.
So we have the final round of the 2022 Swedish Open presented by Discmania, and the lead card will go out on their third round. We have a film team
and
here,
we hear
and
Daniel Svensson speaking
production.
Here, the assistant
and
TD,
the first player to tee off
alongside
the
with Henrik Rydén.
The first two rounds on minus 11, the most promising junior player in Sweden, representing Vetlanda Frisbee, Hjalmar Fredriksson.
And we remind you that this guy has not yet turned 15.
Impressive.
Yeah. Already a top player in Sweden.
Ooh, watch out for the OB.
That's okay.
Yep, still in bounds.
One second place after the first two rounds. One stroke after the leader.
And on the right there, you can see me Frisbee and my daughter Ingrid sitting on the bench.
Open champion, sponsored by Latitude 64, Fyndisk, and Carnico, Linus Karlsson.
The hometown crowd goes wild. Nice to see.
Oh, he makes it through.
Similar shot as the previous round, but makes it through this time.
Yeah.
On third place, after the first two rounds, two throws after the leader, representing Ymer Frisbee, Dennis Augustsson.
Another local guy. Actually lives in Alingsås, but he plays for the club in Ymer.
Yeah.
Stay in.
No, that's out.
Unfortunate kick.
And the fourth and final player on this card, on fourth place, after the first 2 days, for three throws after the leader, representing Bollnäs Frisbee, Fredrik Bodell.
Right, we have Fredrik. So curious. I like the song. DuckTales.
Brings you back. And will this be brought back inside? Yes.
Nice. Good look for birdie.
Yeah, I've seen that throw before, but it's amazing every time.
Yeah, it happens.
I don't think he meant to do it, but it's doable.
Yep. And he's happy about it, I think. Okay, here we go. Can it go in? No, that's short. Good line, though.
Yeah. It's well short of the OB. And if you watch the coverage from the second round, you notice that Hjalmar throws lefty backhand and righty forehand.
Yep. And if you haven't watched the previous round, go back and do that.
Yeah.
Nice floaty approach from Dennis. Good no. cleanup.
Yeah, no need for a big putt there.
Did he go over the branch?
Yeah, I think so.
Creative. Wow. He came to play all the way from Bollnäs. I like it. I think that's just west of Gävle, north of Stockholm.
Yeah, I think north of Gävle as well.
You might be right.
Yeah.
Here we go. Tap in par. And the OB bogey for Dennis. So over to hole number two, the short and technical par four. Just avoid the OB on the right side. Try to find this spot somewhere here and then avoid the Mando and get the birdie. I think we'll probably see some birdies here. Kind of a rough angle though from the tee here. It's high. It's very similar to Emil's spot yesterday where he actually made the birdie.
Yeah.
So it's makeable.
Hjalmar hits three as well.
Yep, similar position. Let's see some gaps hit. There we go, big skip.
We remember that from the previous round.
Can that be a stiletto, maybe?
Yeah, maybe. Looked really overstable.
And the lefty forehand. Goes for the wide gap. Or maybe in between those gaps. Unfortunate tree hit.
Yeah, but that could have easily gone OB as well, but I'm not sure if he wanted to play it that way. But
yeah, if you go too straight, you bring the OB into play. It's good that he stayed out of those trees.
Yeah.
It's jail in there.
Still a bit of a struggle to make the par.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a great throw from Dennis.
And he's in the circle, I believe.
Also one of the young Swedish talents.
Yeah, I think it was in the junior division last year.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people showing up for this.
Good to see. And there's a deja vu from yesterday.
Yeah.
Pitching it up. Easy birdie.
Great touch there from Hjalmar.
Good throw.
And the par is not going to be a problem for Fredrik either. Oh!
I took the elevator.
It's in.
Count it.
Pling. Yeah, job done.
Job done. So par for both Hjalmar and Dennis on the round thus far. Two different ways though. One under for Linus and one under for Fredrik after a great birdie on hole one.
And hole three, you gotta hit the kind of a big gap in the middle here. But watch out, it looks easy, but it ain't. We saw Blair making a five here yesterday with a circle hit look for birdie.
Yeah, unfortunate roll from the basket out of bounds.
Yeah, a birdogie from within the circle.
Hope we avoid this time. Overstable putting approach disc, nicking the last tree on the right hand side.
flexing it a little bit more than yesterday. And this with the lefty forehand again. Straight at it, but way too short. Might consider to lay that up, actually, with the OB behind the basket.
Who is this tracking?
Mm-hmm.
Good throw, good throw.
Aggressive, but inbounds.
Yeah. Not too much action on the ground, fortunate. But also smooth throw.
Low flip up.
This looks good. Stay.
Stop right there.
That should be good.
Yeah. Close call, but I think it's in.
Dennis doesn't lay up.
No. That's not the way he moves. Yes.
That's a good scramble putt almost.
Yeah. And from a similar position from where Blair missed it yesterday.
That's correct. That's kind of how that went.
Yeah.
So makes the comebacker. As long as you make the comebackers, you're still in the hunt for the big, long birdie putts, I'd say. Keeping the confidence high. Good birdie from Frederick.
Yeah, made the par. Let's move along.
Some slow-mo action on Hjalmar. Nice form. So hole number four. Also kind of short par four, but as I said last time, distance control is key. Long off the mando, short of the OB is the play. Just to have a good angle towards the green, avoid the trees, and try to make a birdie putt.
Feels like it's very common to like accidentally go too far here and go OB first time around, and then the next round you overcorrect and you go too short.
That's very true. Happened to me a bunch of times.
Yeah, and Dennis is way too short there. He's gonna have to lay it up.
Yeah, I don't see that. Making a birdie. This is a forehand with a slower disc. Touchy throw.
It's got the stability.
Looks
for
good.
It.
Yeah. Wow.
He's there.
He's impressed me thus far, Frederik. It's nice to see.
Yeah.
Focus from Dennis. Looking good. Sit down.
Ooh, yeah, there it's on go. The right side.
I like it.
And then it's perfect.
Yep.
You want to be as far down as possible, basically.
This looks a little bit shorter. Oh, never mind.
Oh,
I was wrong.
Oh.
It was actually long.
Oh. Oh, no.
My mistake. Sad to see they'll be there. Just inches.
And then this lays up.
As you said, yes.
Has to play it for par now. Yeah, there's a gap between the wall there and the OB, as you can see. So.
Yeah, it's not as easy these days to bounce off the rocks. I think that's a correction for this year.
You can't just throw it into the wall and hope for the best.
Do you like that change?
I'm not sure yet. Yeah, but I think so.
Yeah.
I think it's a good call.
Some good throws here.
Yeah. Yeah.
What do you call the color of that shirt, Richard?
Salmon.
Like Ross in Friends, faded salmon color.
Yeah, and this is for par for Linus. It bounces off the tree.
Yep.
Yeah.
Happens to the best of us.
Yeah, and he's disappointed, of course. It's not a hole where he's expecting a bogey.
Great birdie from Dennis.
Yeah, and an example of the great putting skills he possesses.
If his putt is on, it's on from everywhere, I'd say. Fredrik, good birdie as well.
And I don't think Hjalmar, he doesn't look too happy with the start of this round, but let's keep it together now.
Yeah, one over is not what he wants, but still birdies to get. Three under from Fredrik is very good. After this, we'll hear a word from our sponsor.
And we're back at hole five. A really far throw you need to do down to this basket. And you don't want to be on any side of this fairway. There are no OBs, but there are a lot of obstructions.
A hole with a big wow factor, so to speak.
Definitely so.
I think it's a 26 meter difference in altitude from the tee to the basket.
Yeah. Something like that, and it's you can tell when you're on the tee.
Fredrik has the box.
A bit early left.
Common mistake.
Flips up nice.
But this is looking great.
If he just gets it far enough down there, that won't be a problem. That won't be a problem, I think.
But that's basically an eagle look. It's early left.
Yeah. That's not even over the walking path over there. But he's out on the fairway.
Yeah, good kick.
Probably have a complicated stance on the cliff there, but let's see how it works out.
Also, same area where Linus hit.
Beautiful view of the gallery here. And Linus got a clean view of the basket.
Yeah, there's over 100 meters left here. That's looking good though. Looking really good.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, that was something else.
Yeah.
Like to see that. Could you imagine an eagle from up there?
That would have been something. That's well played by Fredrik.
Yep. Good throw.
Let's see how Dennis. Oh, first Hjalmar, of course. Bit short.
Yeah, a little bit too low, I think.
Yeah. The easiest par I've seen.
Easiest birdie, actually.
Yeah, birdie. I mean birdie, of course.
Good bid. Oh, just a little bit high.
And as you said, it's really possible to make an eagle here with a great throw and probably good putt as well would be needed, but I didn't see anyone making such an effortless birdie like Dennis will do here.
Exactly.
There it is.
Perfect.
Yeah, let's watch this again.
Using the fairway to perfection. Yeah. Actually snuck through there.
Hits the pin.
Yeah, probably like 2 decimeters too low.
Yeah.
Okay, so back to hole number 6 here. The steep uphill slope that plays well over 100 meters. But still a manageable birdie for these guys. They seem to have quite a big arm, all of them. It's probably 2 lefty hyzers and 2 back and turnovers. Goes with the flip up. Oh, lefty. It's still a birdie look.
And Dennis has a lot of power in his drives. Dennis makes the correction from yesterday, but it's a later tree.
Almost hits the gallery.
Yeah.
Went through that?
Yeah, I think it was kind of a small gap he found there.
Maybe just the camera angle fooling us.
Yeah. Hjalmar almost made it up to the green yesterday on the other side.
Yeah, similar distance. Maybe a little bit longer putt, actually.
Yeah, probably over 15 meters, 45 feet.
Jump putt.
Yeah.
Good effort.
That's not a layup.
I don't think so.
He's actually disappointed.
Yeah, he should aim high.
And Dennis have Kalle Ulvinen on the bag there. Couldn't decide if I was going to say Carl or Kalle.
Both works.
Yeah.
Yeah, Kalle Ulvinen, one of the furthest throwers in this country.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's just amazing.
Yeah, just what he needed after a rough start for the round, but now he's back in it.
And that's even way further there from where he was yesterday.
Yeah, I think you're right. Okay, Fredrik, can you follow?
Mm-hmm. Ooh,
almost.
Good bid.
Some tapping pars. Beautiful green.
And hole 7, where you want to go pretty high up in the air, even for if you have a big arm. And hopefully you can navigate through these trees up to circle 2 or maybe circle 1. We saw Hjalmar making it parked, basically, by the basket.
Yeah, I made it look easy with a backhand turnover. Aiming for something similar today. A little bit lower, I think, but still a better look.
Yeah, from circle 2. He's got that overstable pink disc again in his hand.
I'd say this hole plays similar to hole 13 in a lot of ways.
Yeah. I would say so too.
Similar shot and similar difficulty. That's a long forehand.
Yeah. And
doesn't quite make it.
Oh, did it make the mandatory there?
Maybe it was short of the restricted space.
Yeah.
Hopefully
maybe
so.
Yeah.
That's an important range. Really tight for the lead, by the way. Linus is in the lead now with 12 under, then just 11 under for Fredrik and Dennis, and then 10 for Hjalmar.
Fredrik makes it through for the par.
That's a save.
Might probably keep having the hot round of the lead card.
Yeah, 3 under. 3 under is not bad.
Really good. I wasn't sure if he had a chance to make the par from where he was.
Long bit again. Tickle, tickle.
Let's see if Linus can make a big putt as well. Great angle.
I prefer the high misses, though.
Yeah.
But it's still the same result, of course.
You did not chicken out on that putt.
No, I gave it a chance.
Yeah. You really don't have to on this green, because if you put it past the basket, that's usually not a problem.
That's true. A little bit slope upwards towards the back of the basket.
Not a lot of stuff in the way that can stop the disc.
There we see the leaderboard. Right, so hole 8, a beautiful par 3. Semi-open, but with a tight gap in the middle and a kind of tight green as well. Watch out for the OB on both sides of the green. Shout out to Tim for the great drone footages.
Yeah, it's a bit short, but that's a difficult angle to throw at.
Yeah,
if you're a lefty.
Very tough lefty shot. But it probably save a par quite easy. Go, that looks left.
Yep.
Oh, there's OB down there.
Yeah. No problem, but yeah.
Should have a gap. See Fredrik.
A little bit high, yeah. That's a really low ceiling guarding this green.
That's one of the trees to miss.
Yeah.
I've never thrown from early left, actually. I don't know how it looks like there, back there.
No. Me neither. It's such a brand new hole. Haven't tried all the rough yet.
Almost makes it out.
Yeah. Is it going for it?
Kind of looks like it.
No.
Safe shot.
Yeah.
And good shot.
There's OB close to the basket, so I don't think that's wise.
It was probably the right decision.
Yeah.
Just short of the out of bounds.
That's a nice try.
It's up and down from Fredrik. Fortunate bogey for Dennis. Now they're heading into one of the most difficult holes on the course, actually.
That is so true. If you like difficult holes, you're in for a treat. Because hole 9 is not just far and downhill and blind. There's a lot of trees to be hit. I think we're going to see two lefty backhand hyzers here. You think this spot is where you want to be? You still got a lot of work to do when you get to the basket over here on a hill. And behind the basket, you also have a slope. There's no OB, but you don't need it to make this hole difficult.
Yesterday we saw 4 good drives. Hopefully we see the same here today. That was a little bit too wide, though.
Yeah.
Probably have a gap, but the birdie is long gone.
Yeah, definitely. So Linus made it look easy yesterday. Will he do it again? Or that's okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not where he wants to be. It's going to be hard to make a birdie again. He actually made the birdie here yesterday.
Incredible birdie.
Yeah.
It
looks a little bit tight, I think. Tight on the right side.
Mm. little bit inside.
Yeah, just a little bit. That was looking really good.
Looks like the wind is picking up, but that shouldn't be a factor on this hole.
No, I don't think so. And in the back there, you see Mikael Svensson, president of the hosting club.
Does it keep the turn? Or
no,
not quite.
Not really. It's right next to the where you want to be on the drive.
Yeah, good effort.
Yeah, that's good.
Not bad, playing for par.
No. All he could do.
Looks like the gallery is growing bigger for every hole.
Yeah. I think Dennis is a bit lucky to be on the fairway there. Fredrik is not anymore. Lot of trees.
There you go. Wow.
Instant correction.
Yeah. Far off from the fairway, you are struggling. Dennis is not struggling. That was a great throw. Third shot for Mr. Carlson here. Inside putt for par, I think.
Fredrik goes a little bit too far, and that's going to be a tough putt.
Yeah, this green is deceiving.
So oh, that's good.
That's a good putt.
Yeah.
Great par.
He's staring right into that slope.
Yeah, we saw some rollaways the last time. Hopefully we do not have to see that this time. Wow. All right, so he saved the double bogey, if you can say that.
Mm-hmm.
Great putt.
And double bogey. That's just really common on this hole this weekend.
Yeah, it's been a bunch of bigger numbers.
And Dennis for a well-deserved par, I think.
I agree.
Good drive, nice upshot, and a nice putt.
Bogey for Hjalmar. Okay, so after the front nine, we have Linus in the lead with 12 under, and then the others are tied at 9 under.
Yeah, and Josef Berg is still in the mix, also a local player here.
Thank you for watching, and see you on the back nine.